Hello everyone, you are welcome back to my channel. To my returning subscribers, and if you are new here, I am Nurse Esther, the nice nurse cares. If you are a student nurse and you wish to expand your knowledge in a variety of nursing topics, this channel is for you. So, without wasting much time, let's dive right into our topic for today, which is adrenalectomy. Adrenalectomy is a surgical removal of one or both of the adrenal glands. One adrenal gland is situated on top of each kidney. So we have two adrenal glands, one on each kidney. As you can see in this diagram, it's like the kidney is wearing a cap. The removal of the adrenal glands could be as a result of different disease conditions, which I am not mentioning in this video, but we are going to be dealing on the pre and post-operative care of a patient that has had an adrenalectomy. So let us go right into the pre-operative care. In your pre-operative care, you monitor the electrolytes levels and correct any electrolyte imbalances. This is life-threatening because one of the functions of the adrenal gland is to regulate sodium and electrolyte balance. So when there is a dysfunction of the adrenal gland, it affects the electrolyte and sodium balance. Another pre-op care is to assess for these arrhythmias, the speed and the rhythm of the heartbeats will be abnormal. Is the heartbeat so fast? And you do this by monitoring the vital signs. Check for the pulse, you auscultate the heart rate, and you can also monitor the ECG on the screen. Monitor for hyperglycemia. You monitor for hyperglycemia using the glucometer or withdrawing blood for laboratory tests. Protect the client from infection. Administer glucocorticoids as prescribed. Glucocorticoids are steroid hormones that are vital for life. It regulates the body's homeostasis, stress, and immune response. Now, let us discuss the post-op interventions. If you enjoy my video, please give me a thumbs up. Thank you. Post-operatively, monitor the vital signs and record. Monitor the intake and output. If the output is less than 30 ml per hour, notify the healthcare provider immediately because this may result in acute kidney injury and may indicate impending shock. Monitor weight daily. Monitor electrolytes and serum glucose level. Monitor for manifestations of adrenal insufficiency like Cushing's syndrome and Addison disease. Assess the dressing for any drainage. Monitor for paralytic ileus. Auscultate for bowel sounds. Administer glucocorticoids and mineralocorticoids. These are hormones vital for life. If the client has had both adrenal glands removed, he will need hormone replacement therapy. Watch my other video for the functions of the adrenal glands. The link is somewhere at the top of this video, and it is also in the description below. Watch that video for a detailed explanation of the functions of the adrenal gland so that you will understand why this patient needs an hormone replacement therapy. Provide pulmonary interventions to prevent atelectasis, that is lung collapse. Teach the patients how to do deep breathing exercise. Incentive spirometry, how to use that incentive spirometer to do chest exercises for lung expansion, and splinting the incision when coughing by placing his hand lightly on his incision when he wants to cough. Give health education on the importance of hormone replacement therapy, which may be for life if both adrenal glands are removed. Instruct the clients regarding signs and symptoms of complications, such as under-replacements or over-replacements of hormone therapy. Instruct the clients to wear a medical bracelet all the time. Thank you very much for watching. See you in my next video.